Voter suppression rears its head in Florida yet again. After attempting to purge voters from the state's rolls, Florida's Republican governor, Rick Scott, has been ordered to stop the process by the United States Department of Justice. Although Scott claimed his administration was merely trying to remove non-citizen voters from the rolls, an analysis by the Miami Herald found that Hispanic, Democratic, and independent voters were the most likely to be targeted by a wide margin. The DOJ maintains the purge is a violation of the 1965 Voting Rights Act, which sought to protect minority voters from discrimination, as well as the 1993 National Voter Registration Act, which outlaws roll maintenance within 90 days of an election. Joining us now to shed some light is Mike Papantonio, the host of Ring of Fire Radio and president of the National Trial Lawyers Association, Michael Waldman, the executive director and president of the Brennan Center for Justice at the NYU School of Law, and still here with us, Vice President Al Gore. Thank you all for your time tonight. Mr. Papantonio, let me start with you. You have been involved in the litigation down in Florida. What is going on there? What is Rick Scott trying to do, and will he get away with it?
Well, I think the most important thing is if you're a supervisor of elections in Florida right now, you have some things to confront. First of all, the U.S. Justice Department have told you, if you are a supervisor of election, that what you're doing by purging these rolls is illegal and to stop it immediately. That's the first thing you have to confront. Second of all, your own attorney, the very people that you've hired as general counsel to advise you statewide as whether or not you're doing it is legal or not, he's told you it's illegal. Don't do it. Stop it immediately. And he said that for a couple of reasons. First of all, you're not complying with the law as it's written in the Voters' Rights Act. You haven't gotten prior permission to engage in this purge. And more importantly, Governor, is you have a situation where you're 90 days out. That area that you have to do this has passed. Right. And so with that type of information in front of them, a supervisor of election has to be very, very cautious, especially when he knows that people have been prosecuted for doing the very things that they may be engaged in.
Mike, you've made a great opening argument. If I were a judge or a jury right now, I'd be saying, you know what, Rick Scott, what you're doing is illegal. Stop it. Don't do it. We're going to send you to jail or do something horrific to you. Michael, but this has been going on for quite some period of time. It is endemic not only in Florida but around the nation. You at the Brennan Center have been fighting valiantly to protect people's voting rights. Explain why this continues to happen.
Well, you're exactly right, Eliot, that this comes on the heels of many, many efforts in Florida and unfortunately all over the country to cut back on voting rights that we've seen in the last 2 years. It's the biggest cutback in voting rights since the Jim Crow era. You've seen laws in state after state, and in Florida, there was a voting law passed last year that basically cracked down on that pernicious social problem of voter registration.
Right.
It imposed all these fines.
And we want to get rid of voter registration, right? It's a bane in our society.
A government policy that works. And what happened is it put all these burdens and fines and penalties on voter registration, and the League of Women Voters, who was our client, you know, a well-known subversive organization, had to shut down its entire voter registration operation in Florida. But fortunately, last week, a federal judge blocked that law and said that it was an affront to democracy, an affront to voting rights. And that's actually what's happening all over the country now. The wave of anti-voting laws is meeting stiff resistance from courts, from the Justice Department, and even from voters in many states.
You know, in fact, Mr. Vice President, I want to come to you. You referred earlier in the show to ALEC, which is the sort of right-wing group that writes legislation for business interests, and they've been pushing these voter ID laws through state legislatures. And now, fortunately, there has been a popular uprising, and companies that had funded ALEC are pulling back. How do we begin, how do we support those efforts? Because these voter ID laws are pernicious, and they're so fundamentally anti-American and anti-democratic.
Well, they're also racist because they are aimed at African Americans and Hispanic Americans predominantly. This whole effort represents an assault on democracy itself. And it's a very cynical, well-planned strategy that goes back quite a few years. And one of the authors of the strategy was on videotape at one of the gatherings of this right-wing group. Spelling out exactly why. He said, I want fewer people to vote, and here's why. And he just spelled it out. And so they have drafted these voter suppression laws and farmed them out to these right-wing legislators and governors who will do their bidding, and then they rubber stamp them and put them into law. Now, in this case, as Mike and Michael have said, It's clearly a violation of federal law, and they're going to have to stop it.
You know, Mike, let me ask you, you know, if I were the judge sitting on this case, as I said, you made a great opening argument, not surprising for the president of the National Trial Lawyers Association. But let me ask you the factual question. Is there indeed a problem? Is there voter fraud that's running wild through our system, or is this just a fictitious issue in the first place?
If there is, Governor, they haven't been able to show it. As a matter of fact, they've been asked point blank, where is the problem? Bring the people forward. As a matter of fact, it's had just the opposite effect. There's a case where a 91-year-old World War II veteran was told he can't vote. He came forward and said, I've been voting for years. What's the problem? And I think what's happened is those types of cases are rising more and more. The importance of Florida, as you know, Governor, is it's not just about Florida. Colorado, New Mexico, where you have large Latino populations, there's an effort to purge there. This is the Selma right now. Florida has become the new Selma, Alabama. It has to, the fight has to take place here. And so I think everybody's all in on this one.
Look, as the Vice President said, there is a racial overtone to this. It's quite public, and I think it's not below the surface. It's overt. I can tell you, Mike, to your point, when I was Attorney General, then Governor, the issue of voter fraud is wheeled out all the time. It does not exist anything close to the proportions they want us to believe it is. It is a canard that they use to suppress the vote.